All right, everybody, what's going on? What's popping? It's your man Frank over at Views from the Man Cave. All right, welcome. Welcome to View from the Man Cave, a place for honest, intellectual, and informative dialogue and discourse about all things related to masculinity and manhood, responsibility and respect, provision and protection. Let's talk about it. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Let's get into it. All right, y'all, what's going on? So I hope everybody had a good weekend. Hope everybody's good. So we're going to get right into our topic tonight. We're going to talk about Ma'at, and we're going to talk about marriage, nurturing, and creating balance in your relationships and your marriages, all those good things. So we're going to get right into that. I just got back from out of town. I had to travel to North Carolina to visit some family. My aunt-in-law, she passed away, and her funeral was on Monday. So my auntie Evelyn, she passed away. My wife and I, we love her. We miss her very much. And we had to drive down over the weekend to go pay our respects to her. My wife actually sang at the funeral and all of that. Due to COVID, we had to do the funeral outside. So it was baking hot, you know what I mean? But we did what we had to do to represent and show our love and support for our auntie. So shout out to her. We love you and we miss you. And on that same day, on Monday as well, was my wedding anniversary. You know what I mean? 14 years in the game. Celebrating marriage, man, celebrating life. It's a beautiful thing. You know what I mean? When I made that decision to extend my hand, to my wife and ask her to marry me, I didn't see it. I didn't see 14 years. You know what I mean? I hadn't done anything for 14 years except live, you know what I mean? But it's been a great ride, man. It's been, honestly, it's been the happiest 14 years of my life. You know what I mean? I can say that openly and honestly. So shout out to my wife, August 10th, 2006. We were married. You know what I mean? We eloped to Jamaica. We went to Ocho Rios, Jamaica. And we eloped out there, got married, had a beautiful ceremony. And then we stayed for 11 days and 10 nights out there in Jamaica. So we lived it up. You know what I mean? We had fun. We did our thing. So it was a great experience for me. So like I said, 14 years in the game. So we got some current events. I was driving back home to Maryland from North Carolina with my wife, and I got an alert on my phone about this right here. You know what I mean? So it is out. It's been out for a few hours now. A lot of people are talking about it on social media and things like that. But, presidential candidate Joe Biden has selected Kamala Harris as his vice president, the California senator and former prosecutor. Kamala Harris has been selected as the vice presidential candidate for Joe Biden. I'll say it like this. I don't really have any faith in this ticket. You know what I mean? I think they're going to lose. I thought he was going to lose before this election. I understand why he and the Democratic Party felt like they had to do this. I think they felt like, look, from the last election with Hillary Clinton, the Democratic Party felt like, you know, they took an L as it relates to the black vote. A lot of black voters didn't come out and support Hillary. You know, we didn't vote for her like that. And so, you know, in the press, in the tabloids, you know, black people were somewhat held responsible for Hillary losing. That was the big trending topic after Donald Trump won the election, was that Hillary lost because black people didn't show up. You know, we didn't turn out. We didn't support her the way that we supported Barack. And that was the reason why she lost. I don't really think that was why she lost. I didn't think she was a great candidate. And Trump, you know, he played the role that he needed to play in order to win that election. So it is what it is. But I understand now, you know, the Democrats are starting to, you know, their plan was to galvanize the black vote. You know what I mean? They really don't want to give us any tangibles. They don't want to give us any resources. We said no tangibles, no vote. We want reparations. We want what we're due. We said cut the check. There are a lot of hashtags out there. There are a lot of movements out there supporting our cause, or, you know, attempting to support our cause. And so this is their feeble attempt at trying to satisfy us, in my personal opinion. This is their attempt to say, hey, you know, we need to get black voters to come out. So we're going to do that by nominating the first black female vice presidential candidate. You know what I mean? Someone who finished fourth in her own state, in her home state of California. You know, as it relates to being a presidential candidate, she had to bow out very early. A lot of black voters did not align themselves with her. She did not get a lot of support from black people, from the black community. And so I don't really think she's a great candidate, but I understand what the Democrats are trying to do. They think that this is going to be their way to galvanize the black vote. And you know what? In a way, they may be right. I think they're going to galvanize the people who are already planning to vote. You know what I mean? Up and down my timeline, I didn't really see a lot of support for this. I didn't really see a lot of people happy about it. I saw a few black women who were happy about it. You know, I saw a lot of AKAs who were happy about it. You know what I mean? They plan to ski wheat, you know, all over the place if Joe Biden wins, but I don't think that's going to happen. So this ticket, in my personal opinion, is trash. They really don't offer anything to black people. And I know people will say, well, you know, Donald Trump doesn't offer you anything either. And that's true to a certain extent. But, you know, when you give a political party at the absolute lowest, when you give them 85% of your vote, there should be a higher expectation for them to be able to give you some tangibles and some resources. And we have not been able to get that. And so we're still not going to get it. Kamala has come out and said she's not doing anything specifically for black people only. Up until recently, she wasn't even claiming that she was black. She was Indian. You know, she was Jamaican. She was all these different things. She wasn't claiming to be an African-American. So it is what it is. But at the end of the day, this party, this ticket doesn't offer anything to black people. They don't. So I don't think that black people are going to be galvanized. I don't think that black people are going to come out in masses and vote and vote for Kamala Harris and Joe Biden. So it is what it is. I am planning. I am anticipating Donald Trump being reelected. It is what it is. Hate him or love him. You know what I mean? You're about to get four more years of him. You know what I mean? It is what it is. So, all right. So we're going to get into the topic. So when I did this, when I created this live, I wanted to talk about marriage. I wanted to talk about relationships. And I wanted to talk about my aunt. And I kind of wanted to break all of that down. So what I'm going to do tonight, if you guys can bear with me, I'm just going to give you some stories, man. I told you from the beginning that this is a truth channel. I told you from the beginning that, you know, I'm going to be very transparent. I don't have any reason to lie to you guys. I know there are a lot of frauds out there who talk about things and claim to be things that they're not, but that's not frank. So I'm going to talk briefly about some situations that I've been in as it relates to relationships. Probably two, the last two relationships I was in before I got married. So I'm going to start there and then work my way up to you know, when I met my wife and when I got married and all of the things that came with that, you know what I mean? The lessons learned, the trials, the tribulations, all of that, you know what I mean? The disappointments, the growing in masculinity, you know, taking L's and bouncing back, all those good things. So we're going to rock and roll. You know what I mean? We're going to do what we do. So we're going to do it just like that. So my aunt, I'll start right there. If you know anything about my aunt, she is Kemetic, which is, you know, Egyptian, but she's a Kemetic goddess, and she represents balance. You know what I mean? She represents truth, justice, wisdom, law, morality, order, harmony, balance, all of these things. So I wanted to tie her into the live tonight, because when you're in a relationship, you know what I mean, when you're in any type of relationship, the goal is to always have a certain degree or a certain level of balance. You know what I mean? You want to be able to feel like you're receiving what you're giving. You know, if you're a man and you're exhibiting levels of masculine energy, you want to be able to receive balance from that, which in a relationship is you want to receive the nurturing and the nourishment of feminine energy. That is your balance. That is the balance to masculine energy, feminine energy. So if you're a guy, you're in a relationship, that's the balance for you. That's what you're looking for in a potential mate, in a potential partner. You're looking for her to be feminine. You're looking for her to be soft, and you're looking for her to balance you out, and vice versa. You know what I mean? If you're a feminine woman, that's what you're looking for in your relationships. You're looking for masculine energy to balance out your feminine energy. And so balance in a relationship is very important, because when there's no balance, when you feel like, you know, you're doing too much of the work, you know, you're overextending yourself, that leads to stress, that leads to arguments, that leads to, you know, situations that are not ideal. And it could ultimately lead to the end of your relationship, whether you guys just walk away, whether people start, you know, cheating and giving other people energy, whatever. Those things tend to happen when you don't have balance in a relationship. So it's very important. It's very important to seek, to find and to nurture and protect balance. It's very important in a relationship. Being someone who's coming before you tonight, who's been married, you know, 14 years now, I can tell you honestly, it's very important to have balance. And I don't really have to tell y'all that, because, you know, you guys have been in relationships on your own, and you know how important that is. Absolutely. So I see you guys in the chat. Phineas, Gabe, Ultimate Black Man Radio, the House of L, Shantina, what's going on, and a few others chiming in, watching on. So, and also, before I get started, I want y'all to come back and check us out tomorrow night, man. Me and Gabe over at Ultimate Black Man Radio, we have a fire show that we're gonna do tomorrow night. We're going to talk about this WAP. Everybody's WAPing. You know what I mean? Everybody's talking about it. The song, the lyrics, the video, you know what I mean? The visuals, all of that. Everybody's talking about it right now. So Gabe and I, we're going to do a live on that tomorrow night. Tomorrow night, 8:30 Eastern Standard Time. We're going to have a few guests. It's going to be over at the other channel. It's going to be at Ultimate Black Man Radio. So y'all pull up for that. I know Gabe is going to create a thumbnail for that and put it out, so you guys will know what's going on. And y'all will be able to, you know, lock that in and clear your schedules and all that. Get your popcorn ready, because it's going to be fire. It's going to be official. We got a couple guests, Miss Marisank. We got Miss Friday coming through, you know, very, very talented women, very beautiful women, very opinionated. You know what I mean? They stand on what they believe. And so they're going to speak truth, you know, whether you like it or not, whether you agree with it or not. You know, they're going to say what they need to say. So it's going to be a good show. We're going to talk about this WAP thing. You know what I mean? We're going to talk about if it's important. You know what I mean? We're going to talk about if it's needed. You know what I mean? And, you know, so we're going to break that down. We're going to talk about, you know, see what all the fuss is about. So y'all come check us out tomorrow night. So I'm going to start. MB, I see you. Yeah, it's going to be fire. Come through, man. You know what I mean? It's going to be fun. It's definitely going to be fun. You know, we're going to have a good time tomorrow night with that. So y'all pull up. So I'm going to start. So here's the thing. You don't really find a lot of guys who are content creators, who are going to come out and tell you the truth about some of the mistakes that they made. That's not frank. That's not, View From The Man Cave. You know what I mean? I'm going to give it to you real. I have a lot of wins under my belt. You know what I mean? But at the same time, I'm not Floyd Mayweather. I'm not undefeated. I have taken some L's. So, you know what I mean? I'm going to paint a picture for y'all. We're going to talk about a few things. So I'm going to just, you know, break it down and talk about how I went from there to here. You know what I mean? And everything that came with that. So when I was younger, you know, when I finished high school, I decided to go into the military. You know, I decided to go into the army. So I was not patriotic at all. You know what I mean? I was a kid, you know what I mean, from the hood. And honestly, I had no idea what I wanted to do. You know what I mean? I didn't know what career field I wanted to go into. I had no idea, you know, where I wanted to live. I didn't know. You know what I mean? I wasted that time. You know what I mean? When I was in high school, I wasted that time trying to figure out. Coach Ali, I see you, bro. So I wasted a lot of time in high school, you know what I mean? Trying to figure out what I wanted to be. So I joined the military. I joined the army. You know what I mean? I was not patriotic at all. I didn't really care anything about that. I just, at the time, I felt like, you know, I needed something to do. You know what I mean? I couldn't stay at home. I didn't want to, you know, go to college at that time and struggle and work a dead-end job trying to make ends meet. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to get away, and I wanted to travel and do all those things. So I joined the military. I joined the army. I left on my mother's birthday, May 9th, 2002. I enlisted in the army, so I left and went to Fort Jackson, 2002. And at the time, I was in a relationship. I was in a relationship with a young lady. Everything was cool. You know, we were good. You know, everything was on the up and up, you know what I mean? So I left her, went from Raleigh, North Carolina to Fort Jackson in South Carolina for basic training. So I do my little basic training and so I finished basic training. Everything is good. And, you know, my girl at the time, she comes up for the graduation and all of that. And she came with my parents. So we there, you know, I do the little, you know, I graduated from basic. I got my little uniform on. Everybody's happy taking pictures and all of that. And so my mom is pulling me to the side and she's like, yo, you know, your girl is living foul. You know what I mean? And I'm like, Mom, what you mean? Like, you've never really talked like this before. And so she was like, yo, the whole time we rode up here together, you know what I mean? She's on the phone and she's talking, you know, with her roommates, or whatever, in the apartment. She's talking about dudes. She's like, yo, don't let this dude go in my room. You know what I mean? Don't let this dude, you know, come up in the apartment, all of that. So she was like, yo, I just feel something real fishy. You know what I mean? Going on, you know, my mother's antennas were kind of popping off, you know what I mean? So, but I didn't pay it no mind. Cause honestly, you know, I had just been away for 9 weeks. You know what I mean? I hadn't had no cheeks. So I was like, Mom, I don't want to hear that right now. Not right now. You know what I'm saying? Let me enjoy this. You know, let me get these cheeks or whatever. You know, let me enjoy my little graduation weekend. And then, you know, let me have some fun. So after that, I go to Fort Sam Houston. I was a medic. You know what I mean? I was a medic in the military. So all the medics, we train, we go to AIT. That's like your advanced individual training, I believe that's what it's called, your AIT. So all the medics go to Fort Sam Houston in San Antonio, Texas. So I go down there. I was a 91 whiskey. I was a medic. I had to certify as an EMT. So I was a certified EMT. She was talking like that around moms, man. She got real comfortable. You know what I mean? It was crazy at the time. I didn't really, you know, I didn't really know what was going on. I was kind of young and naive in the game. But, you know, so I go to San Antonio. I'm doing my training or whatever. I'm there for like 4 months. You know what I mean? I certify as an EMT. You know what I mean? I'm passing my PT test. I pass my test, all that. I'm good. So I get my orders now. Everybody's getting their orders. We sitting around chilling. You know, everybody has their order. So I'm asking my homies, I'm like, yo, where you going? Where you going? Everybody's like, yo, I'm going to Fort Bragg, or I'm going to Fort Hood. I mean, Fort Bragg is in North Carolina, Fayetteville. for those who don't know. And other people are getting orders like, yo, I'm going to Fort so-and-so. I'm going to Fort Hood in Texas. I'm going to Fort Campbell, Kentucky. I'm going to Fort Drum in New York. I'm going to all these different places. So I get these orders. My orders say 2nd Infantry Division. And so I'm like, I don't know what the hell that is. I never heard of it before. So I go to my drill sergeant. So my drill sergeant's like, look, you know, I show him my orders. I say, where is this? Where am I going? Like, am I going to, you know, am I going to Kansas somewhere, Oklahoma, what? You know what I'm saying? So he was like, Rivers, nah. He was like, I was a private at the time. He was like, Private Rivers, nah, man, you going to South Korea. You know what I mean? I was like, who? Like, where? He was like, yeah, man, the 2nd Infantry Division is in South Korea. You're going to Korea, you know what I mean, for a year. That's a year tour. That's a 12-month tour. So I was like, all right. So I was bugging because I was, you know, I had never been away from home that long. You know, I had traveled out of the country before. I had been to Africa, you know what I mean? But I hadn't lived in, you know, out of the country. So I was kind of, you know, I was a little excited, but at the same time, I was a little nervous too. I had never done that before. I was still a youngin', still young. I don't even think at that time. Yeah, I had just turned 21, actually. I just turned 21. So it is what it is. So I take leave at this time. This is like late November, early December. So I take leave for like 2 weeks. I go home to Raleigh, you know what I mean, see my family, you know, thinking I was going to spend time with my girl at the time, all of that before I leave, because I get these orders. I'm going to Korea. You know what I mean? I'm going out there. And so I go home for 2 weeks and I get up with my girl at the time, and it was just mad fishy. Like, I go over there, you know what I mean? She has these roommates. It was like she had like two roommates in an apartment. So I go over there. I'm like, yo, it is what it is. I'm clapping these cheeks for 2 weeks and then I'm out. You know what I mean? And then I got to go to Korea, do my thing. So I go over there and I'm hanging with her, and, you know, something just didn't feel right about the whole thing. Like, it just felt way off. You know what I mean? I couldn't put my finger on it. So while I was there a few days, and it was this real big blizzard. It was a real big blizzard in Raleigh, Durham. And so a lot of people had lost their power. So a few of her girlfriends had lost power, like in their spots, in their apartments or whatever. So some of them came over, you know, was like, yo, we don't have no power. You know, can we come through, just kind of hang out for a little bit, whatever, kind of kick it. So she was like, bet. She was like, are you cool with that? You know, with a few, you know, friends coming over. I was like, nah, I'm all right. You know what I'm saying? So they came over and we was just kind of kicking and hanging out. And so my girl at the time, she goes to take a shower. This was like early afternoon, I think like midday. I know it wasn't late. So she goes hop in the shower real quick. And so one of her friends come up to me. She's like, yo, she said, what type of relationship do you and so-and-so have? And I was like, what do you mean? You know what I mean? She was like, well, I meant, what type of relationship do y'all have? Like, are y'all, you know, in a monogamous relationship? Are y'all kind of open? Are y'all seeing different people? You know, what's really good? You know what I'm saying? So I was like, to my understanding, this thing monogamous, that's the way I've been playing it. You know what I mean? That's the way that it was presented to me, that we playing this thing, you know, that we're doing it like that. So she was like, so the friend was like, well, nah, like, she ain't really doing you like that. You know what I mean? She's seeing other people. She got a dude that's locked up. You know what I mean? That she go see. You know what I mean? She write him letters. She put money on his books, all that. You know what I'm saying? And, you know what I mean? So she ain't really with you like that. You know what I mean? So I'm kind of shocked. You know what I mean? Wifey in here. Wifey was good. You know, 14 years marriage, we in there. You know what I mean? I'm giving them Frank. I opened up the book of Frank for a minute. So yeah, her friend is like, yo, well, your girl living, you know, she living foul. She got other people she entertaining, and she got a dude that, you know, she's real cool with, that's locked up. And, you know, she go see him and write him letters and put money on his books, all that. You know what I'm saying? Like, she just, you know, she doing a little bit of everything for this cat, you know? So I'm like, nah, like not mine. You know what I mean? Like, I ain't used to this. I'm used to, you know what I mean? I'm used to running through on myself. You know what I mean? I'm used to being Marcus Graham, you know what I mean? On Boomerang, you know, like, that's how I was playing it. I wasn't used to this. So I was like, nah, you bugging. And she was like, nah, I'm serious, yo. I'm serious. Like, she cheating on you straight up and down. So I remember she comes out the shower. We go in the room. And I'm like, yo, is there something you want to tell me? And she was like, I don't know what you're talking about. You know what I mean? I don't know what you're talking about. Like, what do you mean? And I'm like, yo, look, I'm going to tell you one time. I'm going to tell you this one time. I want you to tell me the truth right now. Put everything out on the table. You know what I mean? And we can try to work this thing out. But if you lie to me, if you look at me in my face and you tell me a lie, you know what I mean? You nothing to me. And when I told her that shit, I was lying from jump. I wasn't going to work nothing out. You know what I'm saying? Like, that wasn't my energy, but I had to tell her that to kind of get her to spit it out. You know what I mean? So I was like, yo, so she meant what I said. You know, I said it in a tone and in a demeanor that let her know I wasn't playing. You know what I mean? And so she was like, yo, she was like, okay, you know, I've been seeing somebody else. You know what I mean? You were gone. You know, I was lonely, all that shit. You know what I mean? I'm like, how you lonely with me? You hollering at a nigga in jail. Like, we both gone. You know what I'm saying? Like, we both up out of here. You know what I mean? How he comforting you or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, all right, bet, no problem. You know what I mean? I packed my stuff up, my duffel bag, I rolled. You know what I mean? Left. She crying, you know, don't go. I mean, she on some, what's the old girl name? It's her birthday today, matter of fact, too. The chick from How to Get Away with Murder. It's her birthday today, too. But she was snotting like her. You know what I mean? Crying, don't leave. You know what I mean? Grabbing my arm, you know, my leg, trying to get me to stay, all that. You know what I mean? So I embarrassed her in front of all her friends. I'm like, yo, I'm out of here. I got my stuff. I rolled out. My duffel bag, everything. So, you know what I mean? So I called moms up. I'm like, yo, you know, you ain't gonna believe what happened. You know, this is what happened to me, whatever. You know how moms is. Like, yo, I told you that heifer was filthy. You know what I mean? You ain't want to hear it though. All you saw was the cheeks. You know what I mean? All you felt was cheeks. You couldn't hear what I was saying. So I was like, all right, bet. So, you know what I mean? So yeah, Viola Davis, matter of fact. Yeah, she was not like Viola. Shout out to her. It's her birthday today. I think she's 55 years old, matter of fact. But yeah, she was on some don't leave shit, you know what I'm saying? And snotting and you know, holding my leg or whatever. And I'm dragging her up, but you know what I mean? Like, this is real rap. I don't have to lie to y'all. I'm telling y'all straight up truth. And so I left. I was hanging around the city, you know what I mean, having fun, partying, clubbing, all of that, trying to get as much fun in as I could before I had to go to Korea for a whole year. So I did all that. And so I was set to leave. Like, it was the day before I was supposed to fly out. You know what I mean? And so it was the day before I was supposed to fly out to Korea. And I took my, it was what it was. You know what I'm saying? But whatever it was, I was smitten at the time. You know what I mean? I was young and, you know what I mean? I was smitten. You know what I mean? So I couldn't see. You know what I mean? My glasses were foggy. You know what I mean? I couldn't see. J Dub, what's good, bro? I see you. And so it was the day before my I was supposed to leave to go to South Korea for my tour, you know, a duty out there. So I took my mom out to eat. Went to this nice little seafood spot that my mom and I would always take her to in Raleigh, right off Capitol Boulevard. You know, if you're from Raleigh, you know about it. Took her to this little seafood spot. And we eating or whatever, and she calls me and she's like, yo, you left something at my apartment. And I'm like, no, I didn't. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't leave nothing in your apartment. You know, what did you take out of my stuff? You know what I'm saying? So she was like, well, nah, you left your medical records over here. And so I need to give them to you before you go, you know, before you go to the airport tomorrow. So I knew she wanted me to I knew she wanted to come where I was staying, like, oh, you know, go to the room or whatever. I was like, nah, I don't want you nowhere near me. You know what I mean? But you know what? I got my mom's coming. I'm taking my mom out to eat right now. You know where this spot is. You come over to this spot. You bring me my stuff and we'll do it like that. So so she was like, OK, bet. So she comes to the restaurant. She calls me like, yo, I'm outside. I got your medical records, everything. So I'm like, cool. So we go outside. You know what I mean? So I go outside to get it, and she out there like all the way dolled up. I mean, she got the hair done. She got the nails, toes done. You know what I mean? She got the outfit on with the low cut shirt, you know, chest oiled up. You know what I'm saying? She just went all the way extra with it. You know what I mean? And so she was like, you know, here, you know what I mean? Take your stuff. So I took my medical records from her and I just walk off. I didn't tell her nothing about how she looked, none of that. I just walked right off. You know what I mean? At the time, she wasn't really nothing to me. You know what I mean? But she went extra. I mean, she had the hair done, outfit, you know what I mean? Everything short, everything tight, everything hanging out, oiled up. You know what I'm saying? She went extra with it, you know what I mean? To try to get me to look, I guess, to see if she still had that appeal on me. But I couldn't rock with it. So I was like, yo, I took my medical records. I walked back in the restaurant. All right. So me and mom's is good. I'm at Raleigh, Durham. You know what I mean? I fly to Chicago. Shout out to O'Hare. I always play with my wife and call it O'Hara, but you know, she don't like that. But it's O'Hare Airport, Chicago. So I flew from Raleigh, Durham to Chicago. And then I flew from Chicago. I flew from Chicago to South Korea. So I'm at O'Hare Airport. I'm in Chicago and something just told me, Frank, yo, check your medical records. Like, check your medical records real quick. You don't know what she saw. You don't know what she took up out of there. You know what I'm saying? You don't know nothing. So just check it real quick before you roll. So I'm like, I bet. So I go through my medical records and it's a letter in there. She wrote this whole 4-page letter and shit. Like, yo, I love you. You know what I mean? I made a mistake. I was wrong. You know what I mean? If you don't want to talk to me again, I understand, but I don't, you know, I want us to work on it. I want us to fix it. You know what I mean? I love you, all of that, whatever. So I fly to Korea, you know what I mean? I'm over there and, you know, I check in, everything is cool. You know what I'm saying? But, I was homesick, yo, straight up. I was in Incheon. Matter of fact, that's exactly where I went. I was in Incheon and then I had to go to Camp Castle, you know what I mean? To process and all of that. I was at Camp Casey. No, Camp Mobile was where you go to process. And then the big post was Camp Casey. And then I was down the street at Camp Castle, a small unit. I was in the engineer battalion. So I get there. You know what I mean? Now, at this time, I wasn't the Frank y'all know. Right. I was in the northern tip of South Korea. I was near the DMZ. I was near the demilitarized zone, right near the North Korean border. So I was up there where it was hot. And so I get over there and I'm not the Frank y'all know today. You know what I mean? The ism I have today was non-existent. It was void. You know what I mean? It was a no-go. So I get over there and, you know, I'm kind of homesick. And, you know, I'm on some, you know, I'm kind of simping a little bit. And I'm like, yo, this girl filthy. But, you know, I need somebody that I know. I need somebody to talk to that I know or whatever. So, you know what I mean? I'm over here and I'm like, I don't really know these chicks. And I don't really know these cats like that. And people running around and, you know what I mean, doing their thing already. Cats had already put their bids in and was doing their thing. So I was like, yo. So I got into a little moment and I was like, yo, let me call her up. So I call her. We kind of talking the whole time I'm over there. You know what I mean? And, you know, kind of just talking or whatever, kind of kicking it from time to time, all of that. So fly by like 12 months, right? I come back home. I found out that my second oldest brother passed away. You know what I mean? I was, I wasn't the legend I am today. I had a little simp demon on my shoulder. You know what I'm saying? Back then. So I was talking to the female. I was talking to her the whole time I was in South Korea. And so fast forward like 12 months, I'm getting ready to roll. I'm getting ready to come back home soon. And I found out that my second oldest brother had died, that he passed away. So I was in the field. I was in the engineer battalion. We stayed in the field all the time. You know what I mean? We stayed in the field. And you know what I mean? So, Phineas, you know what? That's real. You know what? I ain't going to front, man. I ain't going to lie to y'all. Straight up. You know what I mean? I was talking to her, but I had a couple Korean chicks, man. You know what I'm saying? I had a couple joints I was out there tap dancing with. You know what I'm saying? But I was out there doing my thing, too. It was happy endings as well. You know what I'm saying? But I did call Shorty back. I did simp a little bit. You know what I mean? I ain't even going to front to y'all. I don't have no reason to. So I was keeping in contact with Shorty back here, but I was over there. You know what I mean? I was getting that ling ling too. You know what I mean? I was, You know, it was ding-a-ling with Ling Ling, you know what I mean, for 12 months or whatever. So, you know what I mean? So I'm getting ready to come back home. I find out that my second oldest brother, he dies. He passes away from cancer, young, like 27 years old. So I'm in the field in my unit, I'm in the engineer battalion. So we in the field all the time. They come get me from the field like, yo, your brother just passed away. You need to go home. So I pack my stuff up and I fly back to Raleigh to bury my brother, to go to the funeral. My second oldest brother passed away. Go out there to bury him. You know what I mean? So I come home, you know what I mean? Find out, you know, my brother dies. And Kelly, I see you. So I get back, you know, bury my brother. I get orders to go to Walter Reed Army Medical Center. I have no idea what that is. I don't know nothing about it. I call my people. People like, yo, that's in D.C., right? So you're going to D.C. now. So I go up to D.C. and, you know, at the time, they didn't have barracks at Walter Reed. You know, they were going through the barracks and all of that. And I think they were remodeling the barracks. You know, Walter Reed was at the time, it was on Georgia Avenue, uptown D.C., and so I got stationed there. So the barracks weren't, they were being renovated. So they were giving everybody, you know, off post housing. So I had a little apartment, you know, on the outside of D.C. in Silver Spring, this little spot called a chateau. You know what I mean? Shout out to the chateau. I was on the 11th floor, nice little crib. I could see the city, you know what I mean? Nice little joint, you know what I mean? So old girl calls me like clockwork. You know what I mean? All this is happening. I move into the apartment, whatever, everything, you know what I mean? Everything is popping off lovely. She calls me like, yo, you back home now. I think we should rekindle this thing. I think, you know, what do you think about us moving in together? You know what I'm saying? Like, what do you think about us moving in? And so I did it. You know, I was like, I bet, you know what I mean? You come up here, you stay with me, whatever. My brother thought I was the biggest simp in the world. You know what I mean? And I was. He was like, yo, how you going to move to D.C.? How you going to move to Chocolate City? You know what I mean? It's all these honeys running around. You got black women. You got women from all over the world going to school out there. You know what I mean? You got all these women in D.C. Man, D.C. is it, man. D.C. is a gold mine. You know what I'm saying? It ain't nothing but go-go, mumbo sauce, and cheeks. That's the only thing. Everything's out there popping. And you're going to sit here, you know what I mean, and bring a girl with you. You know what I'm saying? You're going to sit here and bring a girl into that with all these women up here in D.C. Like, you crazy. And I'm sitting here like, yo, you know what I mean? I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But I was simping. I was simping hard. So she come up. She lived with me. You know what I mean? I'm doing what men do. You know what I mean? I'm paying the bills. You know what I mean? She don't want for nothing. She was working at the time. I think she was like trying to go to nursing school, whatever. So she was working at a hospital. You know what I mean? Yeah, man. I told y'all, man, you know what I mean? I had to learn later on, man. I didn't know C-Book back then, man. I didn't know cats, man. So I had a little simp moment, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, yo, Phineas, yo, man, there are a lot of lesbian chicks here too. Matter of fact, I wasn't even going to get to that. But later on, man, I had a couple, a lesbian couple that moved in with me, you know what I'm saying? So they were... And they weren't really lesbians either. They were, you know, I think they were kind of bi, because one of them was like, were kind of, you know, come in the bathroom and try to peek when I was in the shower. But that's another story for another day. But, yo, so, but yeah, all these women up here, you know what I mean? And my brother was like, yo, you bugging. All these women, you know what I mean? You a smooth dude. You a fly dude. Like, what you doing? Play the field. You know what I mean? Why you trying to settle down? But I ain't want to hear him. I was like, yo, you know, we got history, whatever. I was simping. You know what I mean? Had a master's degree in simping at the time. So she come up, she move in. I'm doing what men do. I'm paying bills, all that. You know what I mean? I'm taking care of everything, food. She don't want for nothing, right? So one time, like, I started noticing stuff. I was like, yo, every few months, she would want to go back to Raleigh. She'd be like, yo, I miss my friends or whatever. I miss my girls, whatever. I want to go back and hang out with them for the weekend. So I was like, I didn't think nothing of it at the time. I was like, I bet. You know what I mean? You don't have to be here. I'm the one in the military. I'm the one on orders. You know what I mean? If you want to go chill with your girls, whatever, that's cool. So she would do that like consistently. And then my brother called me, my younger brother, because at the time he was smashing one of her friends. And he told me, he was like, yo, this chick, man, she living foul. Yo, I'm with them. You know how I do. I'm in the club. I got bottles, whatever. I see them. I'm with the girl. You know, I'm smashing her friend. So, you know, I bring the girl to the club with me, or she come up, pull up on me. Your girl up in there, she living reckless. You know what I mean? She living reckless. You know what I mean? Straight up. And she out here wilding out, man. She foul. She filthy, man. I told you about her. But, yo, you need to cut her loose. Still wouldn't listen, right? Still wouldn't listen at all. So, long story short, she come back. You know, I started noticing that a lot. So one time she was like, yo, it was like the holidays. It was like a Thanksgiving. She was like, yo, I want to go back home for Thanksgiving. And I was like, and I had to work. I was at Walter Reed. I had to work at the time. So at first I was like, all right, you know what? I ain't even tripping. And then I thought about that thing and I was like, man, nah, man, fuck that. You know what I'm saying? Cause I'm like, listen, like, you know what it is. You know what I mean? You with me, you lined up with me. You know what I mean? So if I'm here, you know, you should want to be here too. You know what I'm saying? So I came at her like that. And then she was like, well, yo, I think we need some space. You know what I mean? She hit me with the space joint, you know, Space Jam or whatever. So I'm like, what you mean? Like, I mean, what you mean you need space? Like, from space from what? From who? And she was like, yeah, I just don't, you know what I mean? I think we need space. So I was like, yo, I mean, so I gave it to her. I couldn't do nothing about it. So she started getting real extra, man. Like, yo, she would like, she'd be calling dudes, yo, all that stuff. Like me and Gabe talk about like the 7 signs of disrespect. She got to like 3 or 4 off the rip. You know what I'm saying? So at this time, you know, we doing a little space thing. She like, yo, I'm a, you know, so I'm like, if you need space, you might as well just get up out of here. You know, let me, I'm gonna do me then. I'm gonna do what I do. You know what I'm saying? So she was like, well, nah, I mean, I need space. Like, we're not gonna be together, but I need to, I'm staying here for another 2 weeks, you know, before I leave to go back to Raleigh. You know what I mean? I already got an apartment and all that. So I'm like, so she had all this in the works from the beginning. And I'm like, yo, nah, you getting out right now. I was like, fuck that. You getting out right now. You know what I'm saying? So I take the key or whatever, you know what I mean? I take the key, all that. I come back home one day from work. She back up in the crib. I'm like, what you doing here? She's like, what you mean what I'm doing? So I go to the leasing office at the time. I'm like, yo, why you let this chick back up in my apartment? And she was like, and they were like, Mr. Rivers, well, you know, you have her on your lease as an occupant. You know what I mean? So she's not just somebody that's randomly living with you. Like, you put her on your lease. You know what I'm saying? So you can't put her out. You know what I mean? If you come up, if you take her key, or she lose her key or whatever, all she got to do is come up to the leasing office and get another key, because you put her on your leasing agreement as an occupant. So it's another, like I told y'all, man, I was simping. I was young. I was immature. I didn't know what was going on. I didn't even know that all of this stuff could happen like that. You know what I mean? This was like my first apartment for real. You know what I mean? So I didn't know none of that. So I'm naive. I'm out here naked, blind, dumb to everything that's going on. You know what I'm saying? I don't even know what's popping. So I put her on the lease thinking everything peace. And so I can't even put her out now. So I'm like, yo, I bet. So I got to live in this apartment with this female for 2 weeks, right? 2 weeks until she decides she want to move out. She got an apartment back in Raleigh. She's going to move back home, whatever. I got to live with her 2 weeks. So during this 2 weeks, fellas, this chick start getting real, ladies, this chick start getting real reckless, man. She'd be on the phone talking to dudes in my crib, you know what I mean? Loud, like ain't nobody there but her. You know what I'm saying? Getting real extra, man, real, real disrespectful, violating me in my own crib. You know what I'm saying? And there was nothing I could do about it. I couldn't put her out. You know what I mean? Because I was young and naive, put her on the lease. So I couldn't put her out. You know what I'm saying? So she living reckless, going out with cats, you know what I mean? On the phone with dudes. You know what I mean? I go to work. I come home from work. You know what I mean? A dude gave her a card. You know what I'm saying? Talking about, you know, I had fun. You know, you look real sultry and shit. Like, nigga gave her a card, all that. She put that shit on the table. You know what I'm saying? She put it on my dining room table, my G. You know what I'm saying? So I got to see this. You know what I mean? So, yo, so I'm going to tell it. I'm gonna break that down too. I'm gonna get to that. So, so she getting real reckless, real, you know, violating, disrespectful, all breaking all rules. So one night, you know what I mean? I had enough of it, yo. You know what I mean? I'm like, I'm not coming home. I'm not going to work. You know what I mean? Coming home and she in there on the phone with a dude. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just feeling like a sucker right now. You know what I'm saying? But I felt trapped. There was nothing really I could do. I could, like I said before, I couldn't put her out. So I was like, yo, so one night she was doing it and I took the phone. Matter of fact, it was my phone. She was on my phone plan. You know what I'm saying? She was one of my fave fives or some shit. You know what I'm saying? It was my plan. You know, it was my phone. So I'm like, yo, so I grabbed the phone. She was on the phone with a dude. I take the phone, go outside. You know what I mean? I'm talking to the dude like, yo, I don't know who you are, what y'all doing. You know what I'm saying? I don't care. I don't give a shit, but this is my crib. You know what I mean? And you know, you or her, y'all ain't going to violate me or disrespect me at all. You know what I'm saying? Like she got to be here for another week or whatever. You know, y'all shut that down. She can come stay with you, whatever. I don't care, whatever, but she not talking to another dude on my phone in my crib. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's not going to happen. So she come out there running, trying to get the phone. We arguing, yelling. I'm still in my uniform. I just came home from work. I'm still in my uniform. So we out here arguing. We go back in the crib, you know, arguing, yelling, all that. So one of my neighbors called the police because one of my neighbors hear the commotion. He hears me arguing. He hears her arguing. So he don't really know what's going on. So one of my neighbors calls the police. So the police pull up. You know what I mean? I'm in there. In my apartment, in my uniform, you know what I mean? The cop comes to the door like, you know, what's going on? I'm like, look, officer, nothing going on. You know, me and this young lady right here, we just had a disagreement. It got a little heated. Everything is good right now. You know what I mean? Cop was like, all right, sir, I hear you. Thank you for your service, all of that. But I'm going to tell you like this. If I come over here, if we have to come back over here tonight, one of y'all going to Central Cell Block. And you know who it's going to be. You know what I mean? You know who it's going to be. So he gave it to me straight like that. And so I go out in the car and I just take a ride, man. I call an OG up back home from Raleigh. I call an OG up. I'm like, yo, look, this is my situation, man. This was going on. I'm naked, man. I can't do nothing. You know what I'm saying? She in here, you know what I mean? Violating me, disrespecting me. I can't put her out. You know what I mean? If I get a little bit too assertive, you know, people calling 12 on me, I could lose everything behind this chick. You know what I'm saying? If I get locked up over some domestic stuff, you know, I got UCMGA, I got UCMJ I'm looking at, I got demotion I'm looking at, I got all this kind of stuff. Like, I don't know what to do. You know what I'm saying? So I call an OG up like, yo, I need some help, man. You know what I mean? Because, I didn't know. I didn't have a lot of game. You know what I mean? My game was on a fourth grade level. You know what I'm saying? My game was you know, it didn't really exist. So my OG was like, look, yo, you got the money. It ain't even about the money. Just go stay in the hotel. Go stay in the hotel for a week. You know what I mean? You got the bands on deck. I know how you get down. Go to a hotel for a week. You got to get up out of there. You know what I'm saying? Because if you stay, you know what I mean? Something could happen. She going to keep violating you and your manhood going to kick in. You might do something that, you know, you may regret. You know what I'm saying? You may, in a heated moment, you may put hands on this young lady. You know what I'm saying? You may grab a shake or whatever because you frustrated. You know what I'm saying? So you need to just go. You got the bands. Go to a hotel. You know what I'm saying? And just stay until she leave. You know what I mean? That's your best play right now because she going to keep violating you. And she kind of enjoying this shit, seeing you look like a sucker. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, you in the apartment, you can't do nothing. You vulnerable, you helpless. You understand what I'm saying? She kind of low-key getting off on this power dynamic that you have put her in, this pedestal that you put her on, where she can do all this and you can't really touch her. You know what I mean? Figuratively, literally, whatever. So he was like, yo, just leave. You know what I mean? Go get you a hotel. You know what I mean? Stay there for a week. Until she leaving and you go back and do what you got to do. All right. So I was like, bet. So I stayed at a hotel, you know what I mean? And So me and the homies were going to go out one night. Me and a few fellas, you know, guys in the army I was with, we were like, yo, let's go to a Wizards game. You know what I mean? Let's go to a Wizards game and let's go, you know, to stadium or whatever. Let's go to a strip club. Let's just chop it up. Have some fun. I was like, bet. Like, I need to get out anyway. I didn't really tell them about what was going on. So they didn't know. So I was like, yo, this is good. I get out with the fellas. You know, we pop some bottles. We go to a game. You know what I mean? We, you know, we smack some cheeks a little bit, you know, throw a few bands out there. We have some fun. So we go to the game and we get there a little bit early. So like, if you know anything about DC, where the Wizards play, where it's the Capital One Center now, but it's right down, it's right in, right at Chinatown. No, it's right at Gallery Place, which is near Chinatown. So we got there a little early. So everybody was like, yo, let's just go to Hooters real quick. It was a Hooters like right there near the Capital One Center, you know, before the game started. So we was like, yo, we'll go to Hooters, get some wings, you know what I mean, get some drinks or whatever, get some beers, just chop it up until the game start, like bet. So we go in there and I see this female sitting by herself. And I'm like, yo, like, I'm gonna go get my swagger back. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm, you know, I allowed this other chick in my crib to jack my swagger. So I'm going to go over here and get my swagger back real quick. So I approach this young lady. We get the rapping. You know what I mean? I get the number, whatever. I'm like, yo, I'm with the homies. We're going to run around real quick, but I'll get at you later. You know what I mean? We was chopping it up. Everything was good. You know, she was laughing, all of that. So I get the number. I roll out. So we have fun that night. You know, I call Shorty. We talking, we kicking it, we hanging out. You know what I mean? Came to the room, all that. Like, we was doing our thing. So I'm feeling good. I got that simping up off me, or at least I thought I did. At least I felt like it at the time. You know what I'm saying? So so I had to go back to the apartment real quick to get something. She had maybe like my ex had like 2 days before she left to go back to North Carolina. So I go back to the apartment to get something. And she come up in there and she like, yo, you know, where you been? I'm like, you don't ask no man where he been. I've been where I've been at. You know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna be where I'm gonna be at. You know what I mean? Straight like that. Like, you don't talk to no man like that. You know what I'm saying? I'm gone and I'll be here when I'm here. You know what I mean? And I'll be there when I'm there. So she was like, well, you know, let's smash right now. Like, I feel like I feel like smashing. I want to smash. So I was like, I thought about it. You know what I mean? And I was like, all right, bet. You know what I mean? I was like, yo, all right, I'm with you. I got it. And so she was like, well, this don't mean that we back together. You know what I mean? It just mean that we, you know, we just smashed or whatever. You know, that's what it is. So I was like, all right, bet. No problem. I was already off it. I got a little bit of swagger back or whatever. So I wasn't even really tripping at the time. So I was like, all right, bet. So we smashed. You know what I mean? I go in the room and call old girl up that I met at the Hooters. You know what I'm saying? So like, it was nothing. Like, I beat it down, you know, washed off, go in the room, call the girl I met at the Hooters the other night. Like, it was nothing. We having a whole conversation like it's nothing. So my ex come up in there and, you know, she all crying, hurt like I did her wrong. You know what I mean? Crying like I did her wrong. Why you do that? You know what I'm saying? I thought we was, you know, whatever, whatever. So I get it. You know, I felt like at the time, like, yo, she was just trying to play her hand. She was just trying to put a test out there to see if I still cared. You know what I mean? If I still had any type of interest at the time, but I didn't. I was over the joint. So anyway, so she leaves in a couple days after that. So I come back from work, you know what I mean? And she moves out. You know, her dad come up. You know what I mean? Her dad comes up to get her, help her pack her stuff. She goes back to Raleigh, whatever. So I come back to the crib. Everything cool. I got the new shorty now. She slide in like it's nothing. She come through the crib. You know what I mean? She cook or whatever. She was going to this school in D.C. She was going to American University, and she was from California. You know what I mean? Real, real dark chocolate joint. She was from Compton. And she was going to school at American University, and she spoke fluent German. She spoke German. You know what I mean? I ain't never heard nothing like that. But so we was kicking it or whatever and having fun doing what we do. So I'm getting the swagger back a little bit. And this is around the time that I start hearing about cats like Flex, like Tariq Nasheed, the Mac Lessons, You know what I mean? I started really plugging into my OGs at this time. You know what I mean? Started tapping back into them, and they were giving me a lot of game. Like, yo, you, this where you went wrong. This what you did. You know what I mean? I understand why you did it. You was brought up in a single parent home. You know what I mean? You didn't really have a lot of men around, and the ones that were around trying to give you game, you weren't listening to them. You know what I mean? And so you start taking all these L's. You know what I'm saying? So I really started plugging into my OGs, getting a lot of ism under my belt. Heard about Tariq. So, you know, play or be played, the automacking, you know what I mean? All of that, you know what I'm saying? The Mac lessons, everything. So I'm just soaking up all this game. I'm getting my swagger back now. So the new girl, so she was like, she was cool, but she didn't really want to be like, she wasn't really, she wanted to do other things. Like, she wanted to be on some superhero shit. Like, she wanted to join the Peace Corps and be in Africa, you know, braiding African children's hair and putting on their stocking caps and shit like that. And I'm like, yo, if you over there in Africa in the Peace Corps, who gonna be here making my, who gonna be here cooking grits? You know what I'm saying? Who gonna be here, you know, vacuuming the crib up and making beef stroganoff and shit like that? Who gonna be doing that if you over there in the Peace Corps in Africa or you know what I mean, in Asia somewhere doing that? You know what I'm saying? So I started to see then, like, okay, she ain't really it either. You know what I'm saying? But at the time, I was like, yo, you know, I really got into a point where I started to learn, man, like, dudes, you know, fellas, you have to live your life on your terms, man. And you have to know exactly what you want. Like, you know what you want. And a lot of times when you young or you immature or you simping, you know what I'm saying? You make a lot of mistakes because you start making deals with women. You know what I mean? You start making deals with women and bending over backwards because that's what this society tells you to do. This society that we live in today, it emasculates men. You know what I mean? It emasculates men. It makes men, it turns men soft. You know what I mean? It turns men moist. Man, you get damp out here in these streets because it tells you, it venerates the woman, but it does, but simultaneously it demeans the man at the same time. So it's set up to where if it, you know, to elevate the woman, they got to demean the man. They got to put the man down and put the man in a type of subservient posture. You know what I'm saying? That's the energy that's out here. That's the wave. And a lot of us get caught up in that initially because we grow up in single parent homes. We don't really have a stand up dude in the house that teaches us game that we can look at and see, okay, this is how you're supposed to talk. This is how you're supposed to carry yourself. This is how you're supposed to move in these streets. You know what I mean? You don't really have a guy like that around. And a lot of guys that you see, they exemplify one of the extremes. They either real moist, real simpish, or they real, you know, gorilla pimping with it. They real 10 toes down, real aggressive, you know, real narcissistic. I mean, they're real, you know, chauvinist or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So it's an extreme. You know what I mean? So that's a lot of what we see out here. We see either one, it's either all the way to the left or all the way to the right. You don't really see too many cats, or this society doesn't elevate or promote cats that are somewhere in the middle. You know what I mean? Like I'm not going to be a gorilla on you. I'm not a silverback, but I'm not no pushover either. You know what I mean? I'm going to be assertive. I'm going to let you know what it is, what it's not. You know what I mean? And you can either line up with that or you don't. It's up to you. You know what I'm saying? I didn't really see a lot of that. So a lot of the moves I made when I was younger was real simp heavy. You know what I mean? It was real soft, on the soft side of the game. So I got my swagger back. I started learning, getting some ism up under my belt, and I started making better choices. Even with that female, I was like, yo, you know what I mean? I don't really see this going nowhere, man, because this is what I need. This is who I am. This is what I'm about. You know what I mean? I'm masculine over here. This is what I need. And if you're not willing to do that, if you want to be all over the world doing your thing, that's fine. I'm not going to stop you or make it difficult for you to do that. What you're just telling me is you're not going to line up with the program. And if you're not going to line up with the program, then, you know what I mean? We're wasting each other's time, straight up and down. So so she wound up flying back to California, right? But she used to stay at the crib. She had stuff at the crib. She had a suitcase at the crib, all of that. You know what I mean? I just stashed it back in the closet. Like, I, you know, I wasn't really thinking nothing of it at the time. So I'm playing the field. So she leaves, you know what I mean? So I'm doing my thing like clockwork. I'm at work one night, you know what I mean? This is like a few weeks, maybe a month or so later. I'm at work one night, you know what I mean? I was working the night shift. So I'm at the hospital, Walter Reed. I'm on from 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. at night. And so I'm on there one night and I'm on Black Planet. I have my little Black Planet's profile, you know what I'm saying? And so I'm on there one night, it was late. It was like maybe 1-2 in the morning. I'm on Black Planet, you know what I mean? Just seeing who on there. Not the Black Planet Love Drake, you know what I'm saying? But the regular one, you know what I mean? So back then on Black Planet, you know, you could see everybody who was online at the time. It give you all these names and, you know, links or profile names or whatever. And so I'm on there just scheming through, just skimming through, trying to kill the time. So I come up on this chick page and I come up on there and she, you know, her profile picture, she on the beach in Jamaica. You know what I mean? She got a little bathing suit on. You know what I mean? And I'm like, yo, you know, everything was kind of sitting where it's supposed to sit, you know what I mean, to my liking. And I'm like, yo, who is this chick? You know what I mean? So I come out there. So I hit her a little message. It was 3 a.m. All right, 3 a.m. in the morning. So I see this young lady, little profile pic. You know what I mean? I'm reading the joint. You know what I'm saying? Reading her little bio. Oh, she do this. You know what I mean? She, you know, she sings and she likes to travel and all that. You know, all that shit we put on our profiles or whatever to sound, you know, to sound legit. You know what I mean? And so I'm like, so I hit her with a little message. I send her a kite. You know what I mean? Send her a kite, little message like, hey, what's, so I saw her, right? And I was like, yo, I want to get at her. Like, I want to reach out to her, see what's going on. So I'm like, yo, I know how this social media thing plays itself out, even on Black Planet, even back in the day. You know, I know dudes is reckless. I know dudes is in y'all DMs, wild out, and y'all messages or whatever. So I said, yo, I'm going to do something real smooth. You know, I got to stand out. I got to be different. So I'm going to go through the little profile, and I'm going to pick, like, the smallest thing that she said. You know what I mean? I'm gonna read it. I'm gonna pick the smallest, most minute thing that she talked about, and I'm gonna ask her about it in a message. You know what I'm saying? And so I hit her. I sent her a kite. We start talking back and forth. You know what I mean? Like, we start messaging all the time. You know, all day, every day, we was hitting each other back, just talking about life, chopping it up or whatever. And we start talking on the, you know, we start talking on the phone, and you know, we were just talking about life, you know what I mean? Like, you know, what you want to do, what your goals are, you know, where have you traveled to? What books do you read? You know what I mean? All this kind of stuff, you know what I'm saying? We was just, you know what I mean? Like, just talking, having real legit conversations. She was like, yo, you know, what music you listen to, whatever. I was giving yo, I like this, I like that, you know what I mean? I like jazz, you know what I mean? I was giving all these jazz artists that I listen to, you know what I mean? And so unbeknownst to me at the time, you know what I mean? She was writing all this stuff down because she wasn't really into stuff that, you know, jazz or whatever, and the books that I was reading. So she was writing it down and buying it and listening to it on her own, trying to, you know, learn about me. So so we chopping it up. And so we start dating. You know what I mean? I came out like our first date, whatever, we met up, and like I was, you know, I was still dressing like I was in North Carolina. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just put it like that. You know what I mean? I clearly stood out. You know, wifey said she loved me, but you know, in DC they call you a Bama if your gear not right. You know what I mean? If you're a little off, they call you a Bama. You know what I'm saying? So she said my gear was very Bama-esque. You know what I'm saying? But I did what I did. You know what I mean? I bagged it anyway. You know what I mean? Cheeks will clap, you know, later on. But at the same time, you know, so we met and we started kicking it, hanging out. And things went fast, man. Things went fast. We were together like all the time, every day. You know what I mean? We kind of connected on a friend level. And we were just at a space. I was just in a space where I was like, yo, I know who I am now. And I know exactly what I want. And I know exactly who I want. And I'm not playing no games right now. You know what know what I'm saying? I'm not simping out here. I'm not cupcaking. I'm not, you know what I mean? And look, let me get it straight. I ain't going to lie to y'all either. I don't want y'all thinking the kid was just, look, I had situations that I simped in, you know what I mean? I wasn't a simp all the way. You know what I mean? I had them love me and leave me too. I was Marcus Graham 75% of the time out here. You know what I mean? But even Marcus Graham had a Robin Givens. You know what I'm saying? So I had a few Robin Givens out there, but 90, 75, 80% of the time I was Marcus Graham in the street, straight up. But even the greatest cats, man, even Mike Tyson got knocked out. You know what I'm saying? So you could be a good dude out here and you could be a masculine cat and you could lose your bearings, man. You get with somebody that is a little different and, you know, you let your guard down, man. So as a man, as a masculine man, you know what I mean? You never, ever, ever let your guard down, man. You never put your masculinity down for nobody. I don't care how cute she is. I don't care how thick she is. I don't care, you know, what she says. I don't care at all. You never put your masculinity down, man. You know what I mean? Look, I'm not the most religious person on this planet, but look at it like this. If you're a religious person, if you read a few scriptures in the Bible, I pattern it after Samson, man. You know what I mean? He put his masculinity down. He allowed his masculinity to get cut off in the name of love. You know what I mean? He put his masculinity down. He put his manhood down because he thought that was going to bring him closer to the woman that he was in a relationship with. And he lost everything. You know what I mean? He lost everything. You know what I mean? Doing it for love. You know what I mean? Doing it for clout. And so he thought he could get away with it. Like, yo, I'm this big, strong cat. I'm masculine. I can put my masculinity down for a second. You know what I mean? I could put it on the table. It ain't going to mean nothing. She's not going to take advantage of it. Look at it. She's been rocking with me. She's been in pocket all these years. You know what I mean? I could put the mantle down for a second. I can let her cut the hair off. You know what I mean? I can put the masculinity. I could take it off and hang it up in the closet. You know what I'm saying? It ain't going to really matter. It does matter, fellas. I'm telling you. I've been there, man. You know what I mean? I'm telling you what I know. Don't put it down, man. Listen, I'm married 14 years. I'm not putting my masculinity down for my wife. You know what I mean? And she in the chat. So it ain't no hiding or talking hard when she ain't around. And then when I log off, I go back to being a sucker. No, your masculinity is the most important thing you have as a man. That's the foundation of everything that you're going to do in your life. That's the foundation. That's the rule of engagement. That's what everybody is going to treat you based on your level of masculinity, based on your level of confidence. You know what I mean? That's how people are going to treat you. So your masculinity is your saving grace in these streets. You know what I mean? It's your saving grace. You know what I mean? That's what's going to keep you grounded. That's what's going to keep you protected because your masculinity is under attack. You know what I mean? Everybody's trying to take it. Sometimes even the people you love will consciously or subconsciously test your masculinity, man. Test your manhood. It could be your wife. It could be your mother. It could be your sister. It could be your girlfriend. It could be your fiance. It could be your baby mother. It could be whoever. They have times and moments where sometimes they do it purposely, sometimes they don't. Sometimes it's just a subconscious reaction to something, and they'll do something that puts you in a position where you need to bring your masculinity front and center, where you need to reestablish some things. If you don't put that down, you don't make that mistake that Samson made, you don't make that mistake that I made when I was younger and I was immature. And then a lot of brothers, you know what I mean? At first, when it happened to me, I felt bad. And I called my OG when I was going through it. And he said, Frank, you know what I mean? Just live life, man. Focus on your manhood. Focus on your paper. You know what I mean? You start putting things before your manhood. You start putting things before your paper. And you got laxed. You know what I mean? You got comfortable. And sometimes people will take advantage of that. sometimes people will prey on that and play on that and put you in an uncompromising position. You understand what I'm saying? So you got off track, but now this is a great opportunity because now you get to see the other side. You get to see what happens when you don't guard your masculinity. You get to see what happens when your focus is not on your masculinity and on you getting your paper up and your wealth and resources up. When you take your foot off the gas, when you drop the ball, this is what can happen to you. And he told me, he said, look, man, I know you upset. I know you mad, you know, about what's going on. You feel helpless, but I'm telling you, you get back on track, man. You start getting your paper up. You start focusing on your principles. And you don't waver them and you don't put them to the side for nobody. And I'm telling you, in one year's time, we're going to go to the bar. We're going to have a cigar. We're going to chop it up. And we're going to laugh about this. We're going to laugh about how dumb you looked. You know what I'm saying? We're going to laugh about how stupid you looked 12 months ago. It's going to be so far gone. You're going to be so past it that you can look back on it and laugh like, yo, I was a simp ass nigga for that in that situation right there. I was. You know what I mean? I learned from it, though, but I lost it. I lost my way. You understand what I'm saying? And he was right. Once I got back on my path, once I got back on being on being the man I was supposed to be, you know what I mean? Studying, living life, you know, focusing on my paper, focusing on my principles, figuring out who I was and standing on that. It got better. You know what I mean? And then in the midst of all of that, when I finally put it all together, this feminine woman walks in the door. You know what I mean? She walks up on me like, yo, you know what I mean? I see what you're doing. I see what you're about. And I just want to line up with it. You know what I mean? I see where you're going. I may not understand where you're going. It may not look familiar to me, but I see where you're going. And you're going somewhere right and exact. You're going somewhere that's proper. And you know what? I'll follow you there. And because of the man that you are, because you stand on your principles and you're assertive and you assert your masculinity and you make me feel safe and secure, I'll follow you anywhere. You know what I mean? Just let me know. I don't care. I'll go because if I'm with you, I'm safe. If I'm with you, I'm secure. If I'm with you, I feel like regardless of what could come about, I'm going to be all right because you've proven that to me. You've shown that to me that regardless of whatever situation you've been in, you're going to come out on top. I see your wins. I see the championship belts you got. You know what I'm saying? And I'm willing to line up with that. And I'm willing to follow that. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of times, man, a lot of dudes will go through what I went through. You know, when I had my moment of simpness, of simp energy, a lot of dudes will go through that and they'll get bitter. A lot of dudes will go through that and they'll get upset and they'll start joining these organizations. You know what I mean? They'll start joining these little fake movements. You know what I mean? And they'll start bashing women all day long. Women are this, women are that. Let me tell you what I told y'all a long time ago, men are all about accountability. Men look in the mirror. You understand what I'm saying? I got to a point in my manhood and my masculinity where I realized that all the things that happened to me were my fault. It wasn't that young lady's fault. I don't have no ill will towards her. I hope she married. I hope she happy. I hope she's living her best life. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, we weren't supposed to be together. You know what I mean? She was trying to find something. And whatever she was looking for, she realized that I wasn't it. And she felt like she did what she had to do. And it is what it is. But a lot of dudes will go through a situation like that. I mean, you win some and you lose some. I had a few girls and I had a few women in my life that I did that to. Cried over me. You know what I'm saying? Why you hurt me like this? Why don't you, Frank, call me? You know what I mean? I did this for you. I cooked for you. I gave you the cheeks. I did this. How come you treat me like this? I did that too. I played the game. It's only right. You know, karma makes sure that all the energy that you put out into this world, you get it back. Life is going to do that to you. Life is going to give you, well, not all of it, because I did some things that if it came back to me, I wouldn't even be alive today. You know what I mean? I did some things in my life that if it came back to me, I'd be in jail doing real time, doing double digits. So grace did that. But a lot of stuff that I've done, I got, you know, a lot of things that I did to people, I got that energy back. But men look in the mirror and hold themselves accountable. At the end of the day, I had to look in the mirror and say, yo, you caused that, man. She was able to do that to you because you allowed her to do it. You made mistake after mistake after mistake. Okay. That's life. A lot of people in life are trying to survive. So if you give them an opportunity to cross you, they'll cross you. Y'all know, like you have family members that you afraid to leave money around. You have family members that you afraid to tell certain things to because you know that they'll use it to their advantage to hurt you or to get something up out of you that you don't want to give. Excuse me. So people will use your weaknesses to hurt you. So as a man, you want to make sure that you don't really show weakness, that you are masculine at all times, that you guard it with your life. Because not guarding it with your life could cost you your life. It could mess your entire life up. If you don't know what you're doing, if you're not guarding your manhood and people are violating you and disrespecting you, it's going to cause problems. It could cost you money. You know what I mean? It could cost you your life. It could cost you your freedom. You have to guard your manhood at all times from everybody. No one is exempt. And I had to look in the mirror as a man and say, Frank, you did that to yourself. You know what I mean? You put yourself in that position. People told you for months, for years that she wasn't it, that she was filthy, that, you know what I mean? That she was reckless out here in the street. People told you that for years. So you can't say you didn't know. You can't say the signs weren't there. You know what I'm saying? The signs were there. And you didn't heed those warnings. You didn't see the signs because you were mesmerized by the cheeks. You know what I mean? Or, you know, so you did that to yourself. So I hold myself accountable. There's nothing that has ever happened to me in my life that I don't look at that situation and assess it and say, you know what? How could I have been better? What did I do wrong? Yeah, he did that to me. Yeah, she did that to me. But what did I do? What role did I play in it? You know what I mean? Because the only thing that I can control is me. As a man, you can only control yourself and your masculinity. So you have to look in the mirror. And when I looked in the mirror and said, yo, this is, you know, I did this to myself. I dropped the ball. I put the ball down. I allowed myself to be vulnerable and get played for a sucker in the name of love, in the name of comfort. You know what I mean? In the name of having some cheeks in the bed. All cheeks not good cheeks, brothers. All cheeks are not good cheeks. If you gotta lose your manhood to get it or keep it, it's not good for you. It's not worth it. Never. Facts. Facts. You know what I mean? Coach, man, listen. I think a lot of brothers, man, we need to be more transparent and tell these young brothers the truth. Because a lot of times in these YouTube streets and these social media streets, you have a lot of guys who perpetrate a fraud and they lie to people. And they have people thinking that they always been on top. Some of them ain't never been on top. Some of these cats ain't never been on top. They ain't got a dollar to their name. Some of them not doing nothing they say they do. You know what I mean? But they're leading brothers down the wrong path because they're lying to them. You know what I mean? And they're giving them bad information. So I think it's only right that brothers like me and my man, Coach Ali, man, y'all check him out, Coach Ali's Corner. He has a great channel as well. You know what I mean? But it's our responsibility to teach these young brothers the truth. And the best way for us to do that is to be honest with them. We have lost some. You know, our winning percentage is solid. I mean, we're not Glass Joe in the street. You know what I'm saying? We have a solid winning percentage, but there have been times where we lost. Ali is the GOAT, but he lost. You know what I mean? He lost sometime. And it's okay to tell the truth. And it's okay to tell these young brothers out here that, yo, I took an L, man. Me, not talking, not making up hypotheticals, not talking about, you know, or disrespecting some other brother who went through something, who took an L. I'm talking about me. I took one. Okay. I had a moment where I was simping, where I was cupcaking, where I was making mistakes because I didn't know any better. And I didn't want to know any better. But then I got to a point in my life where I realized, I said, look, man, I get one life. I get one life. You know what I mean? My wife and I just buried my aunt. You get one life and you get one chance in this world, man. You get one shot. How you going to live your life? You going to live it being a sucker? You going to live it being a simp all the time? You going to live it letting people violate you and disrespect you all the time? Or you going to man up? I don't know when my day is going to be called. I don't know when the ancestors are going to tap me on my shoulder and say, Frank, it's your time. It's time to come home. I don't know when that is. And so now I'm at a point in my life where I live like that. I live like I don't know when that time is going to be. So I guard my manhood at all times. I take care of my wife. I love my wife. I protect my wife. I provide for my wife. I take care of my children. You know what I mean? I'm a stand-up brother. Nobody out here can say that I owe them money. Nobody out here can say that Frank did me wrong. You know, Frank brought me on his channel and disrespected me. Or Frank told me he was going to do this and he didn't do it. Nobody can say that because I'm living my life like I only have one life. Because we do. Heaven and nirvana and paradise, those are beliefs. And beliefs are not grounded in facts. So I don't know. I don't know what's out there. What I do know is that I'm here today. And I'm here today and I'm going to live in a masculine fashion. So we got to be right in the exact, and we got to teach these cats better, man. I could do that. I could tell the truth. You know what I mean? I grew up, man, a lot of us grew up in these single parent households and we don't really see what a man is. A lot of issues that we throw at black women, we go through the same things as black men. We grew up in the same house she did. How we different? We grew up in the same house. We got the same mother. You know what I'm saying? We grew up in the same neighborhood. So whatever situation she's experiencing, we've experienced them too. We grew up too without a man in the house. We grew up too without masculine energy around. We also grew up not knowing what a real man was. We also grew up looking at images and movies and media and then music that told us what a man is, and we tried to emulate it to a certain degree, some of us more than others. But we made the same mistakes. But manhood says you got to look in the mirror. Manhood says, you know what? You have to hold yourself accountable. You know what I mean? So I meet this young lady. We having a ball. We having a time of our life, and you know, and I'm masculine. I got my swagger back. You know what I mean? I got my crown on. You know what I mean? Chakras is on point. Third eye wide open. Masculinity popping, oozing it. You know what I mean? And ravishing Rick Rude with the ism. You know what I mean? Ravishing with it. And so I meet this young lady, we kicking it, we having fun. You know what I mean? She's like, yo, I'm, you know, you leading this. You know what I mean? No issues with me. None. I know who you are. I know who I am. I know what my place is. I know where your place is. I know what the balance is. We're back on my art now. I just brought it all the way home. Balance. When you're in a relationship, man, make sure you get balance. Make sure you're with somebody that understands who you are as a man and knows how to compliment it. Ladies, make sure you get in that balance. Don't just submit to anybody. I know that it is your nature. You know what? It is your divine nature to submit. It is your divine nature to be complimenting and cooperating. Okay. But you don't just do that for anybody. He has to show and prove he's worthy of that. Everything that's masculine in the universe has to prove its value. It has to prove its masculinity. We got to prove our love every day. You know what I'm saying? We got to prove it. You look at anything. I'm telling y'all, man, go look at the animal kingdom. Go watch Animal Planet. Those male animals have to prove their masculinity in order to mate. They they have to, you know, flex, they have to fight, they have to, you know, display certain postures or whatever to get the feminine, to get the female to say, okay, wow, this is on point. This is masculine. I feel safe. I feel secure. Look at how he flexes. Look at how he handled that other lion over there. He whipped that other lion's ass. Look, he's the one right here. He's the one getting W's out here. He's the one standing on his masculinity, looking tall and proud and strong. He's exhibiting these behaviors. So that's the brother right there that I need to line up with. You know what I mean? That's the brother right there I need to line up with. So y'all don't line up with anybody, man. You don't line up with everything. I know a lot of brothers out here talking, they talk a lot of game. They put out a lot of fake ism. You know what I mean? They put out a lot of fake energy about masculinity, what it is, whatever, what it's not. Ladies, you make sure you line up with a brother that's legit. You know what I mean? I'm all about balance, man. I'm all about my art. I have a son and a daughter. I got to give my son the game. I got to give him the truth. I got to give my daughter the truth. You know what I'm saying? It's got to be balanced, man. Make sure you're complimenting each other. Make sure y'all both have the same goals. You know what I'm saying? Make sure. Facts. There's no variables in the animal kingdom. There's no gray area. Lions hunt. Lions eat meat. Lions flex. Alpha males control the pride. There's no gray area with that. There's no, well, maybe, or well, what about this? Or what if? You know what I mean? Facts. We're having all these YouTube beefs, and the only people and the people who are listening and supporting are the ones that are suffering, because there's no real game being dropped. It's all beef. You know what I mean? It's all beef. It's all what this person did. Look, man, I get into some ratchet stuff too, man. Me and my man Gabe, you know what I mean? We talk about some ratchet things. We're going to talk about it tomorrow night. We're going to talk about this WAP thing. We're going to get into it. But you have to have balance in life. Everything in life requires balance. That's my art. That's the scale. It has to balance. You could be a little, you could talk about some ratchet content, but then you got to bring it back to something real. You know what I mean? If you're masculine, you have to balance that out with feminine energy. That's your balance. You understand? You have to have balance. You have to be able to, you know, in a healthy relationship, there's balance. You know what I mean? He's doing this. I'm doing that. He's doing this. I compliment what he's doing by doing this. You know what I mean? I show him love. I mean, I show him respect. Because that's what he wants as a man. He wants respect. I show him respect. In turn, he shows me love. I'm submissive to him. I compliment him. I'm nurturing and nourishing to him. So he balances that out by being masculine, by being a leader, by being disciplined, by being a provider, by being a protector. You know what I mean? By being a producer, by being a builder. That's the balance. And ladies and gentlemen, when y'all don't have the balance, don't hang on, man. Don't hang on. I know what that come from. A lot of us, we grew up religiously. You know, we grew up in the church. And that's a lot of times what we're taught. We're taught to forgive. We're taught to hang on. We're taught to, you know, give it to God. We're taught to pray for a miracle. Pray for, this is your year to break through. You know, y'all going to break through and he going to marry you. No, he's not. That nigga is not going to marry you. He ain't going to be nobody but who he is. And if he ain't masculine, if he haven't shown you that and you don't see any type of energy from him that is showing you that he's trying to be something better than what he is, he's not going to give that to you. So hang it up. Walk away. It's going to hurt. You know what I mean? You're going to cry. You know what I mean? You're going to play some her or some shit. You're going to do that. But you'll get over it. You'll be better for it. Stop hanging on in these bad relationships, man, in the name of love. You're wasting time. And you're wasting walls. You're wasting good walls for nothing. You're letting this man, you know, stretch walls out for no reason. He might not even be stretching them out. You just with him because you comfortable. It's all you've known. You know what I'm saying? For the last year or two. You know what I mean? Stop doing that to yourself, man. It's not going to get better. It ain't going to get better till he shows you that he's better. And if he's not going to be better, then it's time for you to roll. Fellas, too. Stop hanging on, man. You know what I mean? Once you put yourself in a masculine posture, she has to line up with that. And if she's not willing to do it, you know what I mean? You have to be willing to walk away. It's okay, man. L's are going to happen in life. You know what I mean? L's, you're going to lose sometime. There's no fault in losing. There's no fault in making a mistake. You know what I mean? There's no fault in it. The fault is staying in it. The fault is making excuses for it. The fault is not getting better. You know what I mean? That's the fault. That's the fault. We all listen. I don't care what none of these Negroes say, man. I don't care what they say on their channels. I listen to some of them. You know what I mean? I'm a content creator and I'm a student of the game as well. So I listen to certain people. I listen to people. You know what I mean? I hear what they say. I see what they do. You know what I mean? I absorb the energy they put out. And I'm telling you, man, I don't care what they say on these channels, man. They have taken L's. These cats will get up here right in your face and tell you all day how, you know, all black chicks are fat and sloppy and ghetto and all of that. And then the same cats will be booed up with a plus size chick. I can't stand single moms. Single moms are the plague on the black community. These single moms, these women out here having kids out of wedlock, they're horrible. And some of these same cats is in the DMs of chicks with who are single moms. Some of these cats is in love and whole relationships with chicks with who are single moms. You know what I mean? Stopping facts. Shout out to Natalie. Don't ignore them red flags, man. I did it. You know what I'm saying? And I was out here like Urkel, man. I was out here like Urkel in these streets, man, for a short period of time, man. Because I ignored the signs. Men do it too. Nothing about masculinity says that you can't be honest. Nothing about masculinity says that you can't tell the truth. You're supposed to tell the truth. You're supposed to be honest. If you made a stupid mistake, you're supposed to admit that. You could put that energy out there. You could tell people the truth. Because you have these listeners on your channels, and you have these kids coming up who think that it's wrong for them to take a L. That they're not human, that they're less than, that they're stupid or they're weak because they took a L. You only weak when you consistently take L's and you don't do anything about it. That's when you weak. Raining woman, I see you. Thank you for coming. That's when you weak. That's when you're at your weakest. So when you're in these relationships, you need balance. You know what I mean? This world, this universe that we live in requires balance. You know what I mean? You have an east and a west. You have a north and a south. You know what I mean? You have a sun and a moon. You have a yin and a yang. You have a masculine and a feminine. That's who you are. That's your history. That's African. Everything in African history talks about balance. The masculine principle and the feminine principle. When you go, all y'all Hotep cats out here, when you Google Kemet or Egypt and you see these sculptures and you see these hieroglyphics and things like that, and you see these netches and all that, you're going to see the masculine and the feminine. You're going to see both. You need both. Own your failures, man. Own them. Every failure that I've ever had in my life, I owned it. If you're not where you want to be in life, it's because it's your fault. It's because you don't want it bad enough. The only difference between you and a millionaire is grind. The only difference between, you know, you look at these great people. You look at these people who've made a lot of money, who are very successful. 80% of that is just grind. 80% of that is just effort. I'm going to outwork you. Floyd Mayweather is undefeated because he outworked everybody he fought. He never took a fight off. Some of my favorite fighters, Mike Tyson's my favorite fighter of all time. He took fights off. He didn't train. He said it. When I was in Tokyo, he said, when I was in Tokyo getting ready to fight Buster Douglas, I didn't train. I had the Holyfield contract signed. Buster Douglas was going to be a tune-up. I was going to knock him out in a round or two, and I didn't train. He said he was over there in Tokyo smashing 5'10", Japanese women every night. When you train for fights, when you in camp for fights, you don't even have sex. It saps your energy. It saps your legs. Those guys don't even have sex. They are completely focused on their opponent. Mike wasn't focused, and he took an L. You know what I mean? Floyd never took an L because he outworked everybody. He was up when everybody was asleep. Right now, if, Kobe Bryant, RIP, respect to Kobe. If Kobe was alive, while all of us are sitting here right now or going to sleep, or hanging out at the club, Kobe's in the gym. Mike was in the gym. Mike ain't in the club. Mike is in the gym. Kobe's in the gym. They lifting weights. They running. They looking at film. They're preparing to be great. If you want to be great, you have to prepare to be great. And a part of you being great is owning your failures, man. You got to own that. Own your failures, man. It's not all these women's. It's not a woman's fault that you won't get chose. It's not. You got to look in the mirror. What posture are you in? How are you presenting yourself to the world? What energy are you putting out there? If you're putting out sucker energy, people are going to treat you like a sucker. Facts. Even good people, even good people will take advantage of you sometimes if you let them. If you keep putting yourself out there to be taken advantage of, a good person will take advantage of you too. Somebody that's nice will take advantage of you too if you let them. Fellas, it's not as much her fault as it is yours, bro. It's your fault, man. What are you doing? How are you presenting yourself? Are you putting your best self out there, man? Don't worry about who she let hit. You know what I'm saying? Don't worry about what degree he don't have. You're not him. You're not him. We look at the same things and see different images, man. I could take my wife to a museum. We can go to one of the Smithsonian's. We can go to the African Art Museum. Or matter of fact, last year I took her to, they had an exhibit for the Queens of Egypt. So we went down there. We're looking at the same images, same pictures, same statues, all of that. We see different things. Stop comparing yourself to other people. Stop comparing yourself to another guy, man. Be you. Be yourself. You know what I mean? And stop being bitter at the same time. Stop being bitter, man. It's whack, man. It makes you look soft. Just get better. Just get better. And if she don't see you the way you want to be seen, then that's her loss, man. And it doesn't mean that she's a bad person. If you come out here and you step to Reigning Woman, if you step to her and you trying to get her to choose up on you and she don't choose up, she ain't ratchet. She's not dysfunctional. You know what I mean? She's not a thot because she didn't want you. She just didn't want you. It's that simple. You know what I mean? All black women ain't bad because the three women that you chose to be with, it didn't work out. Those three situations just didn't work out. And whether you know it or not, you played a role in that. I'm telling you, man, when you look back and you do a real assessment of your life, you do a real assessment of the situation, you're going to learn that a lot of the stuff, a lot of the things that you went through in your life were self-inflicted. You allowed people to dog you out. You allowed your friends to take advantage of you because you felt like you wanted to be included. Or you felt like, I don't feel secure in myself. So in order to be with certain people, I got to let them dog me out. I got to let them treat me a certain way. And it's okay because I get to be a part of the team. That's not okay, man. At the end of the day, you do a lot of it to yourself. You do a lot of it to yourself. So when you come over here to the man cave, you're going to get truth. I'm gonna hold that mirror up, man. I'm gonna hold that mirror up to you fellas, because I talk to fellas most of the time, because manhood, masculinity is the foundation, man. It's the foundation of civilization. It's the foundation of a relationship. You make sure you on point. You make sure you out here chasing wealth, resources. Okay. You out here, you make sure that you are honing your masculinity to the best of your ability. That is your focus. You focus on masculinity. You focus on wealth and resources. That is masculine energy. Feminine energy is focusing on companionship, emotion. That's her role. You playing her role. And a lot of times when you play a feminine role, it's going to automatically, a lot of times it'll turn a woman masculine, because there has to be balance. We back on Ma'ada again, that balance. If you bring a feminine energy, if you bring a feminine energy to the situation, sometimes a woman will naturally gravitate to being more masculine to balance it out. Because you can't have two feminine people. For a prime example, we all know that a lot of y'all are indecisive. Y'all don't know what y'all want to eat. You don't know what you want to eat. All right. So both of y'all can't be indecisive. The man can't say, yo, I don't know. Like, I don't know what I want to eat. You know what I mean? And then your girl say, well, I don't know what I want to eat either. Both of y'all starving. Somebody got to make a decision. It's got to be you. You have to have balance, man. If you play a feminine role, it's going to turn her masculine. In order for her to stay with you, she has to be masculine in order to balance out your feminine energy. A lot of these relationships that you guys get in, fellas, they are manifestations of who you are on the inside. So if it's, you know, it's manifestations of you on the inside, man. You know what I mean? It's just you. It's the energy. It's the universe allowing you to see who you are on the inside. You know what I mean? It's not everybody in the world is dysfunctional, but you. You're the only functional person out here. That's a lie. You know it. You know you play a part in that. You know your energy causes her to act out of pocket. What you think she going to do if you sitting here, you a man, you not working, you not paying bills, you not providing. I'm talking about in a marriage. Like, we're talking about a marriage right now. You in a marriage. You not working. You not paying bills. You at home. You eating up all the chips. You eating up all the gushers. You know what I'm saying? And then you expect her to come home from work and be feminine? That's impossible. She's going to come home and be masculine. She's going to make decisions. She's going to say, okay, we doing this. She's going to say, she's going to play your role, because you put her in that role. You will sit there and play this soft, mushy, feminine role and then watch her become masculine and then get mad at her for being masculine and say she's wrong. She's not wrong. I mean, she is wrong for allowing herself to become masculine, but you help put her in that situation. Because in order for her to be with you, she has to give a certain level of balance. She has to balance you out. You know what I mean? That's real. So fellas, own it, man. Own your mistakes. Own your mistakes. I'm telling you. If you make mistakes out here, if you need help, you know what I mean? You need some masculine brothers around you to kind of give you some game, teach you what's good, give you some ism, put some ism on your belt. Reach out to some good brothers, man. Reach out to me. You know what I mean? If you say, look, man, I listen to other cats, but you know, I went to them, I did a little consultation, you know what I mean? I wasn't really feeling it, you know, whatever. Reach out to the kid, man. I'll give you some game. I'll give you some advice, some real advice, because somebody gave me real advice. And it wasn't what I wanted to hear, but I had to absorb it. I had to take it in. If I wanted to be better, if I wanted to change my predicament, I had to be better. I had to change. I had to do things that I had never done in order to go places that I had never been. Physically, emotionally, spiritually, whatever. I had to be different. You got to be different, so you got to change it up. You know what I mean? Your responsibility in this world is to be masculine. I mean, you have a role to play. Don't let nobody tell you anything different. I don't care about this black girl magic stuff. That's great. I don't care. But I mean, it's great. I don't care about it. You got magic too. You got a role to play too. You know what I mean? You do. You got to play it. You got to own that, man. You know what I'm saying? Stop coming around here faking it, man. Don't do that to yourself. Because when you're not in your masculine energy, it's going to create problems, man. You're going to go through life sad and soft. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be frustrated, man. And a lot of it is because you're not honing your masculinity. What is masculinity, man? Being honest, being upright, telling the truth, saying what you mean what you say, being dependable, being reliable, being competent, being a man of wealth and resources. I'm not saying you got to be a millionaire. I'm not saying you got to be a six-figure person, but you have to be on a consistent path to greatness. Nobody, no man is really content with where he is as far as on the money side of the game. I make great money. I'm up there. Six of them things. I'm up there. But none of us are never really content, man. Thousandaires want to be millionaires. Millionaires want to be billionaires. You know what I mean? So we're never content, but you got to consistently be on that path to greatness, man. You see, Coach Ali, bro, I got to get off. I got to go off real quick. I'm tired of these YouTubers putting up a channel just for the money and not changing lives. Cats will have a channel for 2 weeks, then doing consultations. Facts, man. They're in it for the wrong reasons. Let me say this, and you know what? I'm not going to hold y'all that much longer, but I'm going to tell the truth. There are a lot of people who are in these YouTube streets just for the money. They don't want to help anybody. They don't want to give you real sound game. They just want money. And I know I shouldn't really be saying this, but it's the God, the honest truth. I don't come up on here for money. Like I have a big, beautiful house. I have a beautiful wife. I hear the pitter patter of little feet running around my house all the time. And I love it. I travel, you know. Only continents I have not been to in my life are Antarctica and Australia, and I'm going at some point. And my kids are going too, and my wife is going. We all going. I'm not on YouTube for money. There are people who support the channel. There are people who donate to the channel, and I appreciate that. But if I have to lose my soul, if I have to lose my integrity for a dollar, for likes, for shares, for subscriptions, I'm not doing that. I'm not doing it. I'm not. Everything I get for this channel goes back into the channel. If I get something, it's going to some lighting. It may go to a better computer. It may go to, you know what I mean, a better camera, whatever it is, but it's related to the channel. Not taking y'all money tricking off on. I got trick off money for that. Not taking y'all Cash App money and throwing it on my wife when she dancing for me naked. I got money for that already. That's not why I'm here. I'm here for real at the end of the day, honestly, to help brothers, man. If I stay, I'm at like 700, maybe 715 subs right now, 720 subs, somewhere up in there. And that's great. And I would love to get to 700,000, but I'm going to do it the right way. And I'm going to do it at my pace. I'm not doing it. I'm not going to call out some big time YouTube content creator to try to get my name up. I'm not going to take the 50 cent model. I'm not going to get my fame up beefing with somebody that's big in the manosphere. I'm not going to do that. A lot of people do that. I'm not going on everybody's platform. I'm not running up on everybody's panel trying to get likes up, trying to get stuff up. I'm not doing that. I'm giving game. I'm giving real truth. I'm giving wisdom. And in order for me to do that, I have to be transparent. Some of y'all been following these cats for 5 years. You don't know nothing about them. You don't know nothing about them. You ain't seen nothing. They ain't showed you nothing. They haven't given you anything. They haven't given you nothing. They ain't told you nothing about their life. You don't know anything about them. Nothing. I'm going to give you me. All the mistakes, all the trials, all the triumphs. That's what I'm going to give you, because it helped me become better. It helped me become more masculine and more sharp and smart. You know what I mean? So I'm going to do the same thing for you. I'm going to give you me. People can say what they want. You could say what you want about it. You know what? I'm good, though. You know what I'm saying? I'm good. And if you want to be good, you got to own your mistakes. You got to tell the truth. You got to look in the mirror. I'm not really the man I say I am. You're not really the man you think you are. You get up on here and you know what I mean? And you talk about what you do and what you don't do. You really don't. Let me tell y'all something else too. A lot of cats, you know, will say they did all these things. I did this. I did that. When you're in a healthy relationship, when you're in a real healthy relationship where there's balance, I judge, like in my marriage, like we talk of marriage now. So in my marriage, I can't look at the situation and say, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. Because I have to look at, it's not only about what I do, but it's about how my wife responds to it. You know what I mean? We have to speak the same language. We have to be on the same page. I could tell my wife, my wife could tell me all day, every day, that she respects me, that she submits to me, that she loves me, that she'll follow me anywhere. But if she tells me that in Spanish, it doesn't mean anything. Why? Because I don't understand Spanish. I don't speak it. So you have to exhibit your essence in a way that your partner can understand if you're in a healthy relationship. You know what I'm saying? It's like if I can make the best 5-star dish in the world. I could take my wife to the best restaurant in DC, Michelin star, you know, $25 peas, a la carte, everything. I could take her to one of, you know, a really nice restaurant. But if they serve food she don't like, it doesn't make a difference. If she's allergic to seafood, it doesn't matter that I took her to the best seafood restaurant in the city, because she's allergic. She's not going to respond to that the right way. So you got to tailor your leadership in a way that the people who follow you and love you and support you, that they can receive it. You know what I mean? So, yo, man, I'm gonna end it, man. I know I could go on all night, man. It's strong up in here, though. We got a lot of people watching. I appreciate that, man. I appreciate that love and energy. But I just want to wrap it up by saying this, man. Make sure you get that balance. You got to make sure you have that balance. You know? Make sure you have it. My wife, she's at home. You know what I mean? She's at home. She works from home. My wife is an accountant. You know, before I met her, you know, we met later on. She went to college. She became an accountant, you know. Shout out to Bentley University in Massachusetts, Walter in Massachusetts. She's an accountant. So in this household, I'm the CEO. I'm the CEO. She's the CFO. And she'll tell you that. You know what I mean? Balance some chicken wings, man. Balance some chicken wings with a little. You gotta make sure you got enough Old Bay and enough mumbo. It's gotta be balanced right. You don't want the wings too wet. You know what I mean? You don't want the wings too wet. You don't want them too dry. You know what I mean? It's about balance out here. You know what I mean? But brothers, make sure you balance, man. Make sure that you defend your masculinity at all times. You protect it. Make sure that you hold yourself responsible and accountable in every situation you get in your life. Before you blame anybody, before you blame the girl you were with, before you blame your job, before you blame feminism, before you blame thought culture, before you blame Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion, look in the mirror. Look at yourself. Figure out what role you played in it. Figure out how you could have been better. And then learn those lessons and be better, so next time you don't make the same mistakes. Everybody in this world has simped. Every man in this world to a certain degree has simped in his life. I don't care what he say. I don't know a man that's never simped at all, that's never cupcake at all. We've done it. I don't care if he's a dating coach, a relationship expert. I don't care who he is. We've all made mistakes. You know what I mean? We all thought we had the game on Smash and we didn't. You know what I mean? Facts. I'm the CEO. She's the CFO. You know what I mean? I say, look, I want to do this. She says, okay, based on what you want to do and based on the other things that you wanted to do as far as saving up, long-term investments, short-term investments, 529 college plan for the kids, you know, retiring at a certain age, you know, buying another property. We looking at some stuff now, buying another house, you know, to just own another house. You have two of them on the portfolio. Based on all of that, all these things you want to do, this is the best play. Let's do it like this. And then I look at it and I say, I like this. I'm going to move with this. Or I say, I don't like it. You know, let's come up with something else. That's it. You know what I mean? Balance, man. Look in the mirror. Be a man, yo. Be a man. This world needs men. This world needs masculine black men. And I don't care what these women say. I know there are a lot of feminists out here. There are a lot of women, if they're honest, they'll tell you the truth. They need you too. They need you to be masculine. They need you to be your essence. Because that allows them, that helps them to be better at being in their essence. Bottom line. Bottom line. It's hard for her to be feminine in this world when you're playing her part. Because in order for her to get in where she fits in, she's going to have to play your part to find a spot. You know what I mean? But man, so y'all come check us out, man. Thank y'all for hanging with me, man. We're on 2 hours right now. I want y'all to come back tomorrow night, 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're going to be over at Ultimate Black Man Radio. We're going to be talking about this WAP thing. I'm telling you, it's going crazy. The song, the video, everybody's talking about it. I had a very interesting conversation with a friend of mine on YouTube. You know, she DM'd me and we had a great conversation about the song. And so I'll give y'all kind of a intro. So if you don't follow me on Facebook, you don't know this. But a friend of mine who's going to be on the show tomorrow night, she DM'd me and she said, look, Frank, you know, I don't understand why men are talking so negatively about Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion in their song. Because for a lot of us, for a lot of women like me who aren't in that life, songs like that, artists like that, give me an opportunity to learn certain things that I can take and use to satisfy my man, to satisfy my husband. You know, a lot of us women learn how to do certain things in the bedroom because we heard Lil Kim say it, or we heard, you know, Nicki Minaj rap about it. And even this song, I've heard Married, if you heard the lyrics, I know Gabe was going to break it down tomorrow night, but if you heard the lyrics, you'll hear it. Like I heard married women on Facebook saying, I'm going to sit on that thing and write my name on it. You know what I'm saying? Like people, you know, so she was like, well, so if women are learning how to be better, you know, freaks for our husbands or our boyfriends, how can we violate and disrespect this content? Like, she was basically saying, look, hoes are necessary. Square women learn from hoes. Square women learn how to be erotic and sexual to their men by learning from hoes, by listening to hoe music, by watching porno or whatever it is, you know. So she kind of put down this argument about, you know, trying to justify, you know, supporting hoes. And so I put it on Facebook. I did it anonymously at first because I wasn't going to put her name out there. She got bold and she got confident, and she got up in the comments and said, it is me. I know it's me. I said this, and it went crazy, you know, hundreds of likes, hundreds of comments, you know, crazy shares. So it just got so big and so many people chimed in on it, that we are going to talk about it tomorrow night. And it's going to be real deep. And ain't going to be the typical, oh, black women are trash. They're clapping their butt cheeks all around. We're going to get real deep into it. You know what I mean? We're going to talk about it. We're going to talk about why are people upset with Cardi and Megan when this type of music has been around forever. We went to North Carolina for my aunt's funeral, and we're playing spades and drinking. You know, that's what black folks do sometimes when we get around family. So they're playing the music, you know, they're blasting the music, and we're drinking and playing spades and having fun. And so they play this song, comes on. It's an old school joint called Eating Ain't Cheating. You know what I'm saying? Eating ain't cheating. If you eat it, if you just eat it, it ain't just eating it, ain't cheating it. You ain't cheating if you eat it. Throw your face in it. It's an old song. It ain't nothing new I heard. You know what I'm saying? So that energy's been out here for a long time. So we're gonna talk about it. We're gonna talk about, you know, if it's just if it's just natural to our community, to our music, you know, how many Hispanic artists are talking like this? How many Asian artists, how many white artists are doing songs like this? And if we're the only ones doing it, why is that? You know what I mean? Why? So we're going to get into that tomorrow night, man. Y'all be on the lookout for the flyer. Gabe is going to put it out. We're going to do what we do. You know what I mean? But I mean, I love y'all, man. If you want to support the channel, you can do that. You know, my Cash App is here. $ View From The Man Cave. I'm on PayPal as well. PayPal, View From The Man Cave on PayPal. You know what I mean? My email is frankjrivers@gmail.com. If you have any questions, you know what I mean, any comments, you have any ideas for topics, I always get, you know, I'm in my ism all the time. The topics flow, it just comes to me. So I write them all down. I have a list on my iPhone of about 20 or 30 topics that I'm going to get to at certain, you know, eventually. But I'm always getting ideas for content. But please, if you have an idea, I know people have hit me already, say, hey, Frank, I would love for you to talk about this, you know, talk about that, whatever. So I put that on the list from time to time. So I will do that. So if you email me, I check my emails often, all the time. So if you hit me, I will hit you right back. I'm on Twitter, YouTube. You're going to see it in my closeout video. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, if you don't follow me on Twitter or Facebook, anything like that, you know what I mean? Reach out to me, add me on. I'll add you back. I'll follow back. And we'll do it like that. So let me see if there's anything in the comments. I don't think I missed anything. All right, man. So y'all be good. Y'all be safe, man. And I will see y'all tomorrow night. And on that note, I'm out. Peace.